The first thing we're going to look at is, what is a dissertation? How is it different from a traditional class essay? What does it even look like? Understanding this is actually really crucial for doing a good piece of work. And so in this video, we're going to unpick this by parts. First, what is a dissertation? A dissertation is about doing research rather than just writing about someone else's research. And you will do that in order to answer a particular question that you will design. Next, how is it different from a traditional class essay? First, it is your own topic. You will have to choose an area and also a question that you want to answer. Number two, it is an individual piece of work. Of course, you'll have help from your dissertation supervisors, but ultimately it will be your own piece of work. Number three, as I've already said, it is about doing research. And so your dissertation will have a very large component of either collecting your own primary data, analyzing your secondary data, or just if you're doing theory, critically analyzing piece of text. And number four, it is very long. So in a normal class essay, which might be around 2,000 words, perhaps 4,000 words, you have a very little space to actually develop ideas, whereas in a dissertation, they range around 10 to 12,000 words. So again, they'll be longer and also much more in-depth. Now, what does a dissertation look like? Normally, a dissertation is divided into chapters, and those are divided into sections. The structure and the number of chapters you will have will depend on your topic, but also on your subject area. A traditional dissertation structure goes like this. Chapter one will be your introduction. This is where you tell the reader a little bit about what you're about to do. Then you will have chapter two, which is your literature review. And think of it as almost like the why of your dissertation. So you would explain to the reader the background area that you're researching, but also why your question should be researched. What's the gap that you're trying to address? Then you have chapter three, which is your methodology of or your research design. And this is, think of it as the how. How are you going to answer that question you put forward in the previous chapter? And again, that will very much depend on your project and the type of dissertation you do. After chapter three, the remaining of the chapters will very much depend on your dissertation. So you can go for a very classic structure and have a chapter four, which is simply a description of your results, and then perhaps have a few chapters after that discuss those results, and then a conclusion. You might instead decide to do a number of chapters organized by themes, or if you're doing a theory dissertation, this structure will be much, much looser. And again, like I say, this will very much depend on the subject and also your own topic.